of anticipation after Canada won a reprieve last night when Sergei Zweigen gave up a goal to the Finns with 15 seconds to go and his team shorthanded. You saw the goal. It wasn't a great one, and he was upset about it. He's backed up by Sergei Kachenko, who gave up a goal to the Swedes a year ago with a second left that allowed Canada to win a gold medal. Zweigen is in tonight against the Canadians. Trevor Kidd, an 18-year-old from Oak Bank, Manitoba, and a draft pick of the Calgary Flames, gets another start for Canada. He's been in for 11 of the 16 goals against Felix Hotman, who allowed four against Sweden, is the goaltender that backs up Trevor Kidd. The referee for this game is Henrik Bjorkman of Sweden. Apparently, the Soviets weren't too happy with his selection in some last-minute politicking, but were unsuccessful in having him removed.
That shouldn't be a surprise, should it?
Doesn't that happen in every big international competition? Somebody doesn't like the official who gets the final game. Bjorkman refereed Canada's 4-4 tie with the USA in a fine, spirited contest. This building, Saskatchewan Place, seats 11,312, and there's not a seat to be had in here. It's almost 30 below outside. It's heated up nicely inside for Canada against the Soviet Union. The final of the World Junior Championship. How do you think Dick Todd's feeling right about now, Gary?
He's a little uneasy because he doesn't know what to expect from this Soviet team. They played last night, as we know so well, and they wanted to win. Whether or not some folks around this country believe it or not, the Soviet coach was humiliated and he berated his players. Dick doesn't know whether this Soviet team is going to come out flying or whether or not Canada might catch them a little flat-footed in the early going.
Well, there are 8 returnees on this Soviet team from last year's championship in Finland, including their coach, Robert Cherenkov. And you wonder if some of them wonder if lightning is striking twice.
When they were down 4-0 against the Finns last night, this Soviet coach just berated his players. He was vicious with them.
Eric Lindros starts at center for Canada. Mike Craig and Pierre Sevigny are on the wings. Carl Dykhouse and Chris Snell are the defensemen. Boris Mutinov. The forward line is a good one with Pavel Bure out. Here's Mirinov to the net. He's stopped by Kidd. A shot just wide as Kudashov came in. Oleg Petrov and Pavel Bure are on the ice as the Canadians come out. Mike Craig carries the puck to Carl Dykhouse. In over the blue line, Lindros in on Kasparaitis, and he moved the puck to Kudashov, the centerman. Across the ice to Bure, and the play is offside, a pass over two lines, 35 seconds in. The Canadians, 4 wins, 7 losses, and a tie against the Soviets. They won last year and trailed 3-0 in the game before they stormed back and claimed the victory in Alaska 2 years ago. They were soundly thrashed.
Second life for the Canadians.
Chris Draper, Mike Sillinger, and Stephen Rice. Canada's second line on the ice. Slava Kozlov leading the second line of the Soviets. Kozlov, the Detroit draft pick number 9 and one of their best players, to the point. The shot on Trevor Kidd, and he holds on. Mokhtov got the shot away.
As in all big games, Canada has got to have great goaltending today from Trevor Kidd.
Because players like Bure and Vyacheslav Kozlov, who was a Detroit draft pick in 90 from Kimmich, will be all around the net. Kozlov is a veteran of 3 of these tournaments. He's a great player along with Bure, and they'll lead this team. Eric Lindros back on the ice. Double shifted early to get his legs early, perhaps. Unless Dick Todd wants to do some line matching, and we'll have to see how that goes. But Lindros, Sevigny, and Craig are right back on the ice. Zolotov couldn't come up with a puck. Mike Craig in the corner. Sevigny centering pass. Lindros in behind the net. Back towards the point, and Slaney couldn't come up with it. Sergei Zolotov with Martiniuk number 19. Kozlov goes for the net. Back with the hit was Sevigny, and he knocks Zolotov to the ice. Pierre Sevigny, number 22, skates down the left wing. Lindros is trailing it. In over the blue line, Lindros can't come up with a puck. Slaney thinks better of coming in to pick it up. Here comes Mikhail Volkov, number 15. Farazin in after the puck, number 14. The centering pass. And Volkov couldn't get a shot away. Kept into the front of the net. Volkov shot. Farazin in after it behind the goal as the Canadians have trouble clearing it. Lindros took a hit, but he bounced right off. Jan Kaminski hit him and bounced right to the ice. Kaminski's number 25. Trying to send it to Volkov. Can't do it. Sevigny in the corner. Dykhouse in to take a man. Blasted Kaminski to the ice. And now Henrik Bjorkman stops the play with Sevigny down on the puck.
The Soviets have been looking for that open ice in Canada's zone. They know also that if they go wide, they may get some chances. Watch Berezin. He just lost possession of that puck, but you knew what he intended to do, and that was to cut in past the defense. Meanwhile, if you want to make Erik Lindros mad, hit him early in the game, and that's exactly what happened.
Jan Kaminski hit him. Didn't do much damage, though, did he? 2 minutes and 30 seconds into the first period, no score, Canada and the Soviet Union. Yushkevich couldn't come up with a puck, Pat Falloon. Manderville's in front of the net, so is Greg Johnson. Here's Manderville, the centering pass, the shot just wide by Dykhouse. Loose puck and they can't poke it into the side of the goal. Kent Manderville with Snell breaking for the net. Greg Johnson in the corner, just put the puck to the back of the net. Konstantin Karatsov moved the puck out to center. Yushkevich. Karpov to the front of the net, and he can't take the puck with him. Kent Manderville is number 21 out of Cornell University. Stopped at the blue line by Zolotov. Dmitry Yushkevich jumps the puck back in for the Soviet Union as they make a change. 3 minutes and 20 seconds into the game. Scott Thornton got into trouble, but moved the puck back to Chris Snell from the Ottawa 67s. Up the middle, Craig Wells tripped. No call from Henrik Bjorkman, the referee. He's just letting them play. Oleg Petrov to Pavel Bure on the right side. Can't cut to the front of the net, in behind it. Tried to center it, and the puck hit the back of the goal. Martin Lapointe, number 26, tries to clear the puck. Can't get it outside of the line. Bure, number 10, to Petrov. His shot way wide of the net into the corner. Moskov, number 7, keeps the puck into the corner. Oleg Petrov is there, in behind the net. And David Harlock for Canada clears the puck to Martin Lapointe, and he ices it. 4 minutes and 3 seconds into the game, no score. It's Canada and the Soviet Union for gold. 19-year-old Pavel Bure is the Cy Young Award winner of this tournament with 12 goals and 3 assists.
Vancouver's 6th draft choice in 89. He versus Erik Lindros has been a popular topic here.
There's a high sticking penalty. Pierre Sevigny pulls himself up off the ice, and Sandis Olslynch is going to the penalty box. Olslynch is a big man, and he'll get a penalty here for high sticking Pierre Sevigny.
Olslynch had his head up. He missed. Didn't get away a great shot. He was trying to clear that puck. We saw him get his stick up.
The Canada goes to the power play. The Canadians haven't had as much success in the power play as the Soviets had in this tournament, having scored 6 times. Soviets have scored 12 power play goals.
Soviets have also been the most penalized team in this league, or in this tournament, and that's kind of a surprise. Canada have been the least penalized team.
Puck is out of play. And the faceoff will be outside the blue line.
There is something called the Fair Play Cup here, and Dick Todd's team right now would win that. Well, that's not exactly what's on their mind. Only a goal, but it is surprising that Canada has been so disciplined, with the exception of a few penalties in their last game against the Czechs. Otherwise, they have maintained their discipline throughout.
Mike Craig on the power play to Chris Snell at the point. Craig lost his stick. Now he gets the puck back. Goes for the net. Can't get the shot away. Craig still on the puck. Gets control. Lindros in front. The pass it escapes. Craig to the front of the goal. And Spigen finally holds on. Sergei Spigen finally got a hold of the puck, but Mike Craig was all over the Soviets' end with the puck.
Mike Craig has just had a great tournament. You can see that he has got 6 goals. Erik Lindros has 6 goals. Mike Craig has played a physical game in the corners and along the boards and has been a real inspiration in their forechecking game.
1:35 to go in the penalty. Lindros, Craig, and Sevigny, Snell, and Brisebois. Canadians win the draw. Patrice Brisebois to the net. Deflected by Yushkevich away from the goal. Kudashov with Petrov. Alexei Kudashov. Nice move he made to the front of the net and cover kid stopped him. Yushkevich took a hit at the blue line and gave the puck up to Erik Lindros. 3-on-3, the Canadians move in. Lindros to the net. Stopped by Spigen and they score!
Had a head of steam up, and he was bound and determined he was going to get in on net. At the last moment, he had to change his mind, but he still tried to put that puck out front. Watch what happens when it does come out front. Sevigny knew where to be.
Sevigny has been getting better and better as this tournament has gone on. He's the man who drew the penalty, and he's the man who scored the power play goal. 1-0 Canada. Erik Lindros draws the assist at 5:12. And Canada has a 1-0 lead, a fifth for Pierre Sevigny. Mikhail Volkov, number 15 over the blue line, was upended by John Slaney. And the Canadians dump the puck back through center. Sandis Oslinch. Sergei Panasin to Kaminsky and Mikhail Volkov. Kaminsky after the puck. Barazin out front. The pass to the front of the net. He'll try and stuff it into the side. And there's a penalty coming up on the play as the Canadians clear the puck. A high-sticking call, and the Soviets will get a power play opportunity. John Slaney goes to the penalty box. We'll be back in just a moment. John Slaney is off for high sticking at 5:54. The Soviets have scored 12 power play goals in the championship and are on their first power play in this game, trailing 1-0. Dmitry Yushkevich. Darius Kasparaitis kept the puck into the right side. Cleared by Kent Manderville, who's killing the penalty with Chris Draper of the Ottawa 67s, David Harlech, and Patrice Brisebois.
You'll see Canada try to play the pass. They are going to try to use their anticipation skills.
Manderville stopped the Soviets and turned them back. 30 seconds gone in the penalty. Draper's been a very effective penalty killer throughout this tournament. He and Manderville on the number one penalty killing unit. Dmitry Yushkevich to Pavel Bure. Bad pass. Manderville broke it up. Darius Kasparaitis, number 6. Can't get away from Draper. Breakaway pass for Bure, and he loves to break away and hang in behind the defense. Oleg Petrov, number 11. Kudashov drifting around in front of the net. Manderville gets the puck down the ice. 7 minutes into the first period. 1-0 Canada. And 50 seconds left in the penalty. Yushkevich over the blue line after the puck. Kozlov's on the ice now, but the Canadians have turned them back again. This time it's Scott Thornton and Dale Craigwell up front killing the penalty. Jason Marshall and Carl Dykhouse to defense. Kozlov over the blue line, carrying the puck. Zhitnik, number five. To the middle, lots of room, fakes the shot. Won't take it. Bukhtov's shot is kicked out by Trevor Kidd. Zhitnik, number five, from the other side. They'll pass it around now. Kozlov, number nine, can't come up with the puck. Marshall cleared it, not out. Hit a skate and bounced to center.
Good job by the Canadians. They were laying back in their own end zone and, again, playing that pass. You can't afford to force the defenseman.
Laney's out of the penalty box. Canadians back at full strength. Here's Sevigny with Lindros breaking for the net. The pass out front. Lindros was tied up by Zhitnik. Slava Kozlov dumps the puck down the ice just wide of the Canadian goal. Outside of the crease, and it's icing against the Soviets. 1-0 Canada in Saskatoon. It's a wonderful night for flag waving and sign making, and this is the most boisterous crowd to see a game in this tournament, as it should be.
Canada knew that this crowd tonight would help them considerably.
One of Canada's best lines throughout this tournament on the ice now, Pat Falloon, Greg Johnson, and Kent Manderville. Manderville just helped to kill the penalty to Slaney, so Canada's back at full strength, and he's in after the puck. Rose Lynch. Up the boards, not out. Marshall's shot. Just got the puck to the corner. Cleared off the boards. Joltov got it out to center. Valery Karpov knocked down on the boards. Greg Johnson topped up the puck to Karpov. Number 16, Karpov, dumps the puck in around on the board. Manderville, the first one there, can't clear it. Patrice Brisebois, number 24, from Drummondville in the Quebec League. Manderville to Johnson and in. Falloon doing the forechecking. Nemsnikov to Karpov and out to center. Konstantin Kravtsov. Poke check just in over the blue line. Here's Karpov with a shot. A weak one that's blocked. Craig Johnson goes to the puck. Clears it to the blue line. Oslinch keeps it in. Jozak played the puck back. Soviets wait for their mates to come off the bench. Darius Kasparaitis, number six, goes after the puck. Lindros intercepted it at center. A return pass didn't get through to him from Pierre Sevigny. Mike Craig is the third member of the Canadian forward line. In goes Chris Snell. Lindros is in front of the goal. Mikhail Volkov stopped Chris Snell. Kaminsky fighting with Lindros for the puck. Kaminsky won the battle, dumping it out to center. Halfway through the first period, 1-0 Canada, as Carl Dykhouse dumps the puck to the end boards. Boris Mirinov. Kaminsky slips up, and Kasparaitis retreats. Mirinov through center. Kaminsky carries the puck. Volkov shot, stopped by Trevor Kidd, and hit him in the chest. Jason Marshall from the Tri-Cities Americans of the Western League to Lindros. And Eric shoots the puck down to the Soviet blue line. Mikhail Volkov popped the puck up to Lindros. Draper goes for the net. Mike Craig has the puck now. Passes it off the boards. Lindros to the in boards, where Craig has been very effective. And he has the puck. Lindros can't get to the net. Mike Craig for Lindros behind the goal. The wraparound didn't quite work.
But it has worked for him many times in this tournament. That big long reach of his fools goaltenders.
9 minutes to go in the first, 1-0 Canada. Alexei Zhitnik. Oleg Petrov. Stopped at the Canadian blue line. Zhitnik lost his stick, but kicks the puck and almost got it to Bure. Brisebois stole the puck, and he had it knocked off his stick from behind. Jason Marshall pumps the puck into the boards. Mike Sillinger from the Regina Pats to the in boards. Steven Rice is there, but Kudashov knocked the puck away from him. Alexei Kudashov, the center on the number one line for the Soviets, with Oleg Petrov and Pavel Bure. Here's Petrov, number 11. Bure's in front of the net. Petrov looking for someone to pass to. Hit a stick. Lucky break for Canada. Nemsnikov, the point man, was poised to shoot. Osnich over the blue line. Oleg Petrov heading for the net. Ran into a crowd, and the Canadians have jammed up the front of the net whenever the Soviets have tried that play. Here's a two-on-one.
Thornton with LaPointe. Off the post. Oh, what a chance for Canada. Martin LaPointe off the post.
Demstikov to Kozlov with Bure in front. Kozlov's turned back. What a frantic pace. 7.5 minutes to go in the first period. 1-0 Canada. Kozlov with Martyniuk. Zolotov coming in wide, but the Canadians turn the Soviets back again. They're 2-on-2. Dale Craigwell, the puck carrier, trying to go around Yushkevich. Yushkevich takes the man. Kasparaitis couldn't move the puck out. On a second effort, he does. Here's Kent Manderville with Ballou. Johnson breaks for the net. Manderville's pass tipped wide by Craig Johnson. Slaney's in behind the net for Craig Johnson. Gets some help from Manderville. Slaney broke for the net, didn't get the pass. Johnson overskated the puck. Yushkevich clears it. Slaney from the point. Keeps it in, and Dmitry Yushkevich brings it out for the Soviets.
The Soviets sure aren't afraid to send a couple of forwards up high in that neutral zone and look for that long pass.
Falloon with his shot. Stopped by Spigen, the Soviet goaltender. Falloon again, trying to center for Greg Johnson. Karatkov. Out to center, turned back again by the Canadians. Konstantin Karatkov gets a shot away. Kidd stopped the weak shot, but it's loose in front of the net and now covered up. 1-0 Canada as they play the Soviets for gold. What a great pace in the early part of this game.
Martin LaPointe headed for that net. Scott Thornton gave him the pass, and look how close it came. Hit the post and right back to the Soviet goaltender.
Then Manderville in front to Johnson.
Johnson just deflected it wide. Canada have had a couple of good chances.
Lindros and Karatkov in the faceoff. Lindros won the draw, but gave the puck away. Zoltov centering pass. And a shot is snapped wide by Valery Karpov, and out of play. You would expect Eric Lindros to be in on many of the goals. Mike Craig has kept pace with him, and Pierre Sevigny has been getting better as the tournament has gone on. Little wonder this line gets most of the ice time it is tonight.
Dick Todd won't be afraid to use this line a great deal tonight. Through the course of the tournament, though, Todd wanted to stick with four lines. He knew what a long tournament this is, and he wanted to make sure for that the final game, a most important game, that he had lots of life within all of his players, and especially the biggest lines.
Used four lines early. Moskov with a shot, just wide of the net. Mironov kept the puck in from the left point. Karatkov on in front. Hiltok can't get him the puck, and it's cleared by the Canadians down the ice. The Lindros line is at one extra shift. He rolled them over very early to get them going. Otherwise, all four lines of play. Scott Thornton has the puck. Martin LaPointe in front. The puck comes back to Chris Snell at the point. Thornton. Bobkov checks him. Konstantin Karatkov comes up with the puck and clears it out to center. Martin LaPointe. Dumps the puck in. The Canadians change on the fly. Sillinger, Draper, and Rice over the boards for Canada. Sergei Vanazin. Kaminsky's shot. Blocked and turned back by Carl Dykhouse. Steven Rice on the right wing with Draper over the blue line. Bouncing puck. Rice couldn't come up with it. Sillinger to Rice. Draper's in front of the net. Rice lost the puck. Sillinger gets to it, though. Steven Rice, the wraparound. He scores!
Stephen Rice is a very determined player. When he came around behind that, from behind the net, he knew what he wanted to do with it. He wanted to stuff it. But he is also aware that the biggest weakness the Soviet team have got is in goal. The Soviet players don't have a great deal of confidence in their goaltending, and Spigen has given them no reason in tonight's game to have any more confidence than they've had.
2-0 Canada. It would be ludicrous to blame Stephen Rice for the loss to the Czechs, but nobody would have felt better about a second opportunity to win a gold medal in this game, because Rice took his first three penalties of the tournament against the Czechs, and they scored twice in the power play.
And those penalties were taken out of frustration, but also out of determination.
Dillinger in front, Draper shot, hit the mask of Spigen. Rice is in after the puck again, Draper out front, Dillinger behind the net. Centering pass is turned back by Kasparaitis. Dillinger fights for the puck. Zhitnik came up with it. Out come the Soviets. Kudashov over the blue line, one-on-one. Stood up nicely by Carl Dykhouse, who also got an assist on the Rice goal. Along with Dillinger at 15-15, Canada leads 2-0. Kasparaitis. Bure back in his own zone. Oleg Petrov. Petrov, number 11, over the blue line. Offside, Soviets. The player of the game tonight for Team Canada receives a fine camera from Canon, makers of the Amazing Portura. Canon's Amazing Portura, the future of photography, design that beautifies. The latest in automatic features, zoom lens, wide-angle to telephoto with zoom flash. Get the future now, the Canon Portura.
After last year's loss of the gold in Finland, and then the loss at the Four Nations tournament, the Soviet press have blamed poor Soviet goaltending for their lack of success. And the Soviet coach, Kerenkov, sure went after his goaltender, Spigen, last night. He berated him after letting in that tying goal.
There's a steal and a shot into the glove of Spigen off Eric Lindros. The Canadians have outshot the Soviets 10-6 and carried most of the play, as the 2-0 score would indicate.
What confuses me a bit, though, is that if his team has so little confidence in Spigen, as to why they continue to leave the zone as often as they do. But that's Soviet hockey. They have great confidence in the passing abilities of their defense. And we'll see Pavel Burilov tonight standing up at the red line. And especially when this team is down by a couple of goals. They'll leave the zone quickly, the forwards will.
As the Finns found last night, this team can strike quickly and strike a lot. In off the draw, Sergei Zolotov, Mikhail Volkov, to Kozlov. There's a Canadian player, 70, down on the ice. He's lost his glove and his stick and appeared to be hurt in front of the Soviet net. As the Soviets ice the puck. Sevigny in every game has been involved with the opposition and may have been trying to draw a penalty here. I'm not going to suggest that he wasn't hurt, because he certainly looks in pain. Hey, there'll be no penalty call.
Well, it's awfully suspicious. We didn't see it. Mokov, the Soviet defenseman, was back there with Sevigny. So did he spear him?
1 can only suspect. Soviets ice the puck. 3:13 left in a fast-paced first 2-0 Canada. Greg Johnson went to the net. Motkov, number 7. Dmitry Motkov, the big defenseman. One of the biggest on the Soviet team. He and Greg Johnson hold the puck against the boards. And more appropriately, Motkov held Johnson and the puck against the boards and stopped the play.
Very seldom in this tournament have we seen stoppages of play because players were holding the puck up along the boards. The referees make them move it.
Kent Manderville would be seen as one of the best pro prospects in this tournament. And the Calgary Flames like that.
He has had an excellent tournament as well, and he has been a real asset on the line of Johnson and Falloon. But he got decked in the game against the Czechs in the first period and didn't have a great second and third.
Mikhail Volkov in on the puck, and a delayed offside is called against the Soviets as the pace slows for the first time with 2:49 left in the first period.
Well, Dick Todd has got his team changing up very quickly. He knows it's a long game, and he needs for them to keep this pace.
Dick Todd, the coach of the Peterborough Petes of the Ontario Hockey League, assisted by Perry Pern from the Northern Alberta Institute of Technology, is currently working with the Canadian Olympic team, and Alain Vigneault, the coach of the Hull Olympics, the triumvirate leading Team Canada. And Team Canada leading the Soviets 2-0. Chris Snell, an undrafted 19-year-old from the OHL, dumped the puck in. Here's Brad May out on his first shift of the game on the left wing, taking Sevigny's spot. And Zweigen holds on. In this tournament, the teams are allowed to have 22 players dressed in on the bench. Canada has had two extra players. Brad May has been the extra forward. Scott Niedermeyer from Kamloops, the extra defenseman. This is where the extra men come in handy because Sevigny has been hurt.
So you don't have to change up all of your lines. You can just insert. And when Brad May comes on the ice, you might know what he is looking to do. Get into the game quickly and take the body. The big 6'1", 205-pound defenseman was injured at the evaluation camp in the summer, and many thought that he wouldn't be available for this tournament. He fooled them.
He's been the extra man on many nights, but he's been the team's biggest cheerleader. John Slaney dumps the puck in. In after it quickly, Pat Falloon, out with Greg Johnson and Kent Manderville. Falloon with Slaney breaking for the net. The pass across the goal mouth. Manderville couldn't touch it. Here's Slaney into the corner. Manderville drops back in his point spot and now chases the puck as two Soviets chase him. Quickly out to center, Falloon to an open wing. Oslich dumps the puck in for the Soviets. Slaney to Falloon to the blue line and now out. Greg Johnson swept it out. Less than 2 minutes to go in the first period. Karpov in behind the net. Centering pass, and in front was Kent Manderville to take the puck away, but he couldn't clear it. Karpov turned, Manderville recovered and got the puck to center. Pierre Sevigny has gone to the Canadian dressing room. The report is he was speared and is hurt. Rice in front of the net. Draper couldn't get him the puck. Boris Mironov checked him. Oleg Petrov to Pavel Bure, number 10. Petrov goes for the net. The pass tipped wide. And the Canadians clear the puck just outside the blue line. Mike Sillinger with Rice and Draper. Sillinger chases the puck. Kasparaitis to Kudashov. In front to Bure, hooked up by Draper so he couldn't get loose. And Chris Snell is back in his own zone deep. It's bumped and knocked over. Made a play up the boards, though, and out to center. They've announced the last minute of the first period. Canada 2, the Soviets nothing. Darius Kasparaitis, number 6.
Last minute of play, Canada will lay back and think about their defense.
Boris Mironov, Oleg Petrov in over the blue line. Centering pass for Kudashov. Kasparaitis moves in, he's checked. And Brisebois just sweeps the puck out to center with 30 seconds to go in the period. Soviets are changing up, as are the Canadians. Late in the first period, Patrice Brisebois. Pass too far for Lindros, and it's icing against Canada with 15 seconds left in the first.
Canada have shown in this tournament so far that they have got some great depth when it comes to winning key faceoffs. Against the Czechs the other night, Dick Todd had no problem sending whoever out, it seemed, to win some big ones.
Wasn't it odd, though, that one of the few faceoffs, you could probably count on the fingers of one hand the number of faceoffs they lost against the Czechs. Wasn't really a clean loss at the end of the game, but it was almost a draw. The Czechs got possession, and Slager's shot deflected into the net.
And that was due to an icing call that Canada had taken.
Off the draw, the Canadians get possession. Out they come. Long blast by Mike Craig on Spigen. Here's Lindros. Craig in front. Running out of time, and the buzzer sounds to end the first period.
Canada played with discipline, and they skated as well as they've skated in this tournament.
Pierre Sevigny and Stephen Rice have scored. Canada has the lead, 2-0 after one. Here's Paul Romanoff.
Ned, coming up during our first intermission, we will talk with Chris Draper, and we'll also visit with Bob McKenzie and chat a little bit about the All-Star team for this tournament. Lots coming up. We'll be right back.
Union, Trevor Kidd for Canada. Looks like the Canadians have found a weakness for the Soviet goaltender, and that's in close.
I wouldn't doubt if the Soviets, who think the Canadians always shoot from any place on the ice, would have practiced with this goaltender with a lot of shots from out far. But in close, he has had some real problems. Spigen doesn't seem to be sharp when that puck is around his crease.
He has played every minute of every game. It came into this game having allowed only 12 goals in six games, one of them he loved to have back. The goal that set up this gold medal game last night against the Finns. And so the second period is underway. The first was at a frantic pace. Let's watch number two as the Canadians nurse a 2-0 lead. Sillinger let the puck go for Rice. Chris Draper at center. Darius Kasparaitis, the last man back, made the play to Kudashov. With Petrov and Bure, the number one forward line for the Soviet Union. Steven Rice, Mike Sillinger, and Chris Draper out for Canada. Carl Dykhouse and Chris Snell, the defenseman. Rice with the shot. Spigen makes the save, then holds on.
Spigen seems to be fine. Anything that's high or from far out, he doesn't seem to have any difficulties with focusing. Give him a few more wraparounds and some two-foot shots and see how he does.
Well, Lindros will accommodate because that's been his favorite play in this tournament, right around the net. He and Craig have worked there extremely well. Lindros is on the ice. Craig is with him, and so is Pierre Sevigny. Left halfway through the second period, and he's back in the tournament. Harlech with the shot off the faceoff, and that was kicked out by Spigen. Craig with a shot, and he snapped one just wide from a sharp angle. Patrice Brisebois. One of seven returnees from last year's tournament on the Canadian team, back in his own zone. Out to Eric Lindros. Stopped by Zhitnik, but the puck drifts in. Volkov. Kozlov spun around at center by Lindros, but he stays on the puck and dumps it in as he took a bump from Brisebois. David Harlech from the University of Michigan Wolverines almost topped up the puck with a pass through the middle. Sevigny couldn't come up with it. Slava Kozlov, number nine, to an open winger. Zolotov, checked by Brisebois, who lost the puck. Zolotov, to the point. Zhitnik with the shot, whistled it wide. Oslich, number two, keeps the puck into the right side, but Sevigny brought it out, and then he was poke-checked. Mike Craig to Eric Lindros. Sevigny's with him, so is Mike Craig coming wide. Kozlov back for the puck. Vyacheslav Kozlov, the Detroit draft pick. Zhitnik. Barazin, number 14, tries to cut to the net, got the puck in front. John Slaney cleared it, not out. Oslich kept it into the blue line. Slaney again with a pass through center. Manderville's after the puck. He's out with Balloon and Johnson on the Canadian forward unit. Oslich. Kaminsky to the blue line, can't get by Craig Johnson. Jan Kaminsky. Bashkatov, the new winger on this line, almost came up with a puck and went for the net. Now Craig Johnson out of the University of North Dakota from Thunder Bay skates through the middle and lost the puck. A slower pace to the second period. Hard to imagine them keeping up that frantic first period pace for a whole game.
Canada have to be very careful at trying to carry that puck into the zone.
Carl Dykhouse. Joltok was right on him, so he made a play around the boards. And up comes Dale Craigwell. Martin LaPointe, Scott Thornton trailing on the play. Kasparaitis, the first man back. Karpov tipped the puck out through center. Chris Snell is back. Up the middle, Karpov couldn't handle the puck. Dale Craigwell can, number 18 for Canada over the blue line. Stopped by Darius Kasparaitis. Martin LaPointe into forecheck. Nemsnikov sent the puck out to center. Dykhouse, who plays for the Canadian Olympic team, gave it away to Pavel Bure. He was poke-checked. Kasparaitis in a crowd around the Soviet bench. They might have had one extra man standing around the puck there.
It happened to them yesterday.
Kudashov to Bure. The pass is way in front of him. Bure bumps with Dykhouse. Bure isn't very big, but he's very solid. 5'11", 175. In the battle of tournament stars, Lindros has 5 inches and almost 50 pounds on him. Oleg Petrov scooped the puck over top of the net. Alexei Kudashov with Bure in behind the net. Kudashov spins away from Draper. Takes a shot, Kidd the save, and he holds on.
I would think that not only does Pavel Bure want to go home with a gold, but he also wants to go home knowing that the Vancouver Canucks saw him in a game that was aggressive, that was quick, and that they would have plans for him in the future. Now, I don't think there's any question they've got plans for him because of his skill level, but that might be the only thing that's on their mind.
His father was an Olympic swimmer, and the Canucks are convinced that he wants to play in the Olympics. Maybe he's got them convinced of that. But many have questioned here whether he is a great pro prospect. Is he the best junior player in the world? Maybe he is, but is he a pro prospect?
And that's a tough one to answer.
Votkov with a shot off the side of the net. Bounce to Lindros, out with Sevigny and Mike Craig. Lindros got around Votkov, but went down as he tried to go for the puck. Kozlov. Forecheck. Pierre Sevigny centering pass. David Harlech takes the shot just wide of the net. Sevigny at the side of the goal couldn't tip it. Friesbaugh with a shot. Spigen got a piece of that. Mike Craig has the puck. The centering pass. Loose puck in front. And it's cleared by the Soviets to center.
Canada again are jamming that net.
They dump the puck in. The Soviets dump it back out. Dumped in again. Canadians are changing as Lindros forechecks all by himself. Falloon's coming in late. Kozlov came up with the puck, turned it over to Pat Falloon. Now here's Kent Manderville. Falloon goes to the front of the net. Johnson races for the goal. Falloon scooped the puck, couldn't get it to the front of the goal. Falloon's held up by Motkov. The fans didn't like Motkov's holding on Pat Falloon. Karpov in front, tried to knock the puck out of the air. It rolls to the post, and Kidd holds on. Boris Mirinov, and it was Mikhail Volkov with a great chance in front of the goal.
That puck just bounced high, and Jason Marshall was trying to get possession of it. Falloon got caught down in deep after having been held by the Soviet player. There's the pass. Now watch. It went off of Jason Marshall's stick, or I should say Manderville's stick initially. And Jason Marshall was doing his darndest with his feet to help Trevor Kidd out.
I thought it was Volkov, but it was Manderville who tipped that puck out of the air and knocked it over the goal. Dale Craigwell faces off against Jan Kaminski. Barazin shot off the draw, went wide of the net. Chitnik kept the puck in behind the net. John Slaney for Scott Thornton by him. Oslich kept the puck in, but only for a moment. Martin LaPointe forechecking on Chitnik. He made a nice move. LaPointe went down and slid to the end board. Alexei Chitnik leading the Soviet rush. The drop pass. Baskatov in front. Back to LaPointe. Oslich number two to the front of the goal. Wide of the net. Rice after the puck, kept in by Chitnik. Now Jason Marshall over to it. Bashkatov on top of him. Barazin chases the puck to Sleen. He clears it around to the boards. Can't get it bounced by Oslinch. Kaminsky plays the puck back to his blue line to Alexei Zhitnik. Soviets are changing on the five. Joltok to the Canadian blue line where John Slaney of the Cornwall Royals from St. John's, Newfoundland skates through center. He's checked. Joltok to an open man, Darius Kasparaitis. Over the blue line. Joltok shoots it. Kid makes the save. Holds on to the rebound. 12:52 left in the second. 2-0 Canada in Saskatoon. Here's a chance for Sergei Joltok, and Trevor Kidd made the save.
When Joltok got that puck, he put it right back onto his forehand side, but Trevor Kidd just stood his ground in the net.
Canada won the draw in their own zone, but coughed up the puck from the point. Volkov shot, blocked by Mike Sillinger. And out comes Stephen Rice. Dykhouse has moved up to join him as Rice dumps the puck in. Then got his stick up in the face of Dmitry Yushkevich. Chris Snell shoots the puck in for Canada. Sillinger wheeled and shot the puck behind the net. Oleg Petrov, the big line for the Soviets, is on the ice. Alexei Kudashov to Pavel Bure, number 10. Petrov, number 11. Checked by Chris Snell. Trying to fend off Bure. Got the puck to the board. Bure's over to get it. Petrov in front of the net. Bure's tied up. Snell had his man, and the Canadians get the puck out to center.
Bure may not have the size that Lindros has, but he sure is strong on the puck.
Rice intercepted a clearing pass. Couldn't center it for Chris Draper. They went 2-on-1 on Mota. Loose puck in front. Shot wide by Chris Draper. Sillinger kept the puck on the board. Rice goes over after it. Canadians are changing on the fly. Pierre Sevigny's off the bench and in after the puck. Ran into Yushkevich. Yushkevich is pretty solid. Soviets return back again at center. 8.5 minutes into the second period. Canada leading 2-0. Here's Eric Lindros to the front of the goal. Mike Craig's backhander off a stick. Pulled out of the air by Spigen, and he holds on. Sevigny was decked by Oslinch.
Now that should have been called. Sevigny was not attacking the Soviet goaltender, Spigen. Lindros fanned on that. Well, actually, the Soviet player got his stick in the way. But now watch. Spigen goes out of his crease. Sevigny was being pushed, but he also just kind of held on to Spigen. Right after that, he got hammered.
Pierre Sevigny has been a thorn in the side of every team in this tournament. Kozlov lost his stick. Mike Craig hustles after the puck. Bumped on the boards. Mironov made the play out to center. Lindros is back for the puck. Boris Mironov. Mikhail Volkov gave the puck away to Eric Lindros. Made a move, lost the puck. Mike Craig shoots him. Over top of the goal, Brisbois moves in. The centering pass. Lindros had gone in behind the net. Volkov tries to come out. Couldn't do it against Pat Falloon. Pierre Sevigny. Lindros in front. Sevigny goes for the net. Shot it wide. Centering pass. Falloon couldn't knock the puck out of the air. Mikhail Volkov can't clear it. Sweeney keeps the puck in. In behind the net. Falloon to the front of the goal. Lindros swept at it. Knocked away, though. Oslinch in front of the net. Sevigny tipped the puck wide as the Canadians put on some pressure, forcing the Soviets to clear the puck down the ice.
Canada were putting on the pressure. They were caught in deep, though.
Here's a pass to Craig Johnson. Swept away by Darius Kasparaitis. Pat Falloon with the puck. In behind the net. Nobody's in front. Manderville's trying to get there. Mironov holding him from getting there. Now Mironov is back behind the net for the puck, and he clears it out to center. Bashkatov. Berezin. Now Bashkatov spins and goes for the net, but he's knocked down. Here's Pat Falloon with Greg Johnson and John Slaney, and he dumps the puck in. 9:40 to go in the second. Canada 2, the Soviets nothing. Kaminsky, shot it wide. Carl Dykhouse for Canada. In over the blue line at the late outside. Nemsnikov for the Soviets, number 4. Sends the Canadians back into their own zone. Martin LaPointe with Dale Craigwell and Scott Thornton, the Canadian forward. Craigwell spun around at center. Woo-hoo. Nice move there by Zitnik to get away from a hit from Scott Thornton.
Zitnik is a pretty big defenseman, too, that plays strong on the puck.
A full house at Saskatchewan Place, and they like what they see so far. World Junior Championship gold medal game from Saskatchewan Place in Saskatoon. Two greatest juniors in the world, Pavel Bure, Eric Lindros.
Eric Lindros has heard it described way too often as his tournament, and that angers him. He says this is Canada's tournament, not Eric Lindros's tournament.
Any comparison of the two must include the fact that Bure is 2 years older at 19, playing in his third tournament. He's also played in a world championship. And Eric Lindros is in his draft year at 17. David Harlan, back in his own zone, give away. They score! Sergei Zoltok, and it's a one-goal game.
Well, that should be a good lesson for Canada right now, not as though they shouldn't have had this lesson well learned already. Harlock came around from behind his net and then just carelessly threw it up the middle. All he had to do was go to the boards with it.
Sergei Zoltok with the Soviets' first of this game. It'll be an unassisted goal at 11:20. And Canada's lead is cut to 1-2-1.
So it's important for Canada right now, and we will see who Dick Todd has got out there in the ice. He's gone with Sillinger's line. They've got to get the puck in and gain the momentum back for Canada.
Canada's played mistake-free hockey for the most part in this game, and maybe the first one cost it. Steven Rice in with the hit on Mironov.
That's exactly what they had to do.
Snell at the blue line, kept the puck in, and shot out to center. Pavel Bure, the big line for the Soviets on the ice, looking for the equalizer. Petrov tipped the puck into the corner. Kudashov after it. Chris Draper for Steven Rice. Alone at center, he dumps the puck in, and he dumps it over the glass.
Dick Todd had enough confidence that Steven Rice and his line would be able to get that puck deep into the Soviet zone and get the flow going again for Canada. The good forechecking. Watch the hit that Steven Rice handled.
Paul Romanek watched the game last night. Any similarities with the Soviets, Paul?
Actually, yeah, Jim. Scaring similarities. It was right about this time last night the Soviets started to pick it up against the Finns, and it was Sergei Zolotov who scored the goal that started the Soviet comeback at 15:02 last night.
The Finns had a bigger lead.
Yeah, 4-0. I don't think anyone in Canada or on the Canadian team really thought that a 2-0 lead in the middle of the second period was very safe against this team.
That's the type of team the Soviets are. If you make a mistake, they'll capitalize on it.
7:49 left in the second. Lindros won the draw. Jason Marshall trying to clear the puck. Mike Craig flips the puck through center. Sevigny. Nemsnikov ran interference for Oswich. Mikhail Volkov. Kozlov over the line. Swept away by Marshall to the front of the net. Slaney cleared the puck. Eric Lindros chases it. Mikhail Volkov with Lindros bearing down on it. Nemsnikov to Oswich. A to center. Kozlov. Over the line, Mikhail Volkov offside as Marshall dumps Kozlov to the ice.
Game sponsors, Kraft General Foods. We'd like to thank them for their support of these World Championships.
Well, this referee that we have in today's game has really let them play hockey. Otherwise, Jason Marshall might have found himself in the penalty box.
Håkan Bjorkman has called two penalties, one to each team. Canada scored on its power play. Soviets did not.
So playing that style, at least calling that style, that should be in Canada's favor, Jim. They should be able to continue to use the body.
Dick Todd still continues to roll over four lines. Yushkevich dumped the puck in for the Soviets. Patrice Puisbois is the first man back. Dale Craigwell now. To center and no further. Kaminsky can't get away from Craigwell to go and get the puck. Harlock to Thornton and in. Not in the point. To the end board. Jikin. Long pass out at center. Sergei Berezin one-on-one. His shot was blocked by Harlock and deflected into the stand. 6:33 to go in the second period. The Canadians lead by a goal on TSN. Greg Johnson from the University of North Dakota, the leading scorer in the Western Collegiate Hockey Association, even though he's missed four games while playing here. Johnson playing on a line with Falloon and Manderville. Valery Karpov over the blue line, the drop pass. Swept to the end boards by Karatkov. Kasparaitis couldn't keep the puck into the point. Johnson hustles out after him. Couldn't get to the puck. Kasparaitis ran interference enough. John Slaney now. Over the heads of all those at center and down the ice. Konstantin Karatkov. To Bure at center. Zoltar. The goal scorer for the Soviets dumped the puck to the end boards. And kept it into the blue line. Here's Petrov with a shot. Rolling puck, and he hit it off the glass. And he couldn't handle the rolling puck as Falloon moves it to center. Manderville. Two on one with Chris Snell. Dykhus comes late. And Snell decides he better get back and play defense with Dykhus up there with it.
Smart move by Snell.
Back the other way comes Bure. Tipped up in the... the referee said no way. He waved his arms as a washing out of penalty instead of calling one. Oslich took a hit, couldn't keep the puck into the blue line. 5 minutes to go, second period, Canada leading by a goal. Oleg Petrov, Bure, couldn't get a shot away. Back come the Canadians, 3-on-2. Mike Sillinger with Draper. Rice goes wide for the net. Draper's shot. Big rebound is cleared. And it comes outside of the blue line. Puisbois shot the puck back in. Bure. Demchnikov. Kudashov. Now to Oleg Petrov. Demchnikov moved up and Draper took the puck away but then couldn't take it with him. Kudashov, number 12. Goes to the net. Kid stopped him. Mike Sillinger. Up the boards for Steven Rice. Puisbois moving up, trying to get the puck out. Kept in by Evgeny Nemchnikov at the blue line. 4 minutes and 10 seconds to go in the second period. The Canadians lead by a goal. David Harlan. Alexei Zhitnik at center.
When Harlock made that pass coming out of his own end zone that time, he knew exactly where to go. Go wide along the board.
Zolotov dumped the puck in. Harlock is back. This time he reversed. Kasparaitis keeps the puck in at the right point. David Harlock on the boards for Mike Sillinger. With Draper and Manderville to the blue line, not out. Zhitnik shoots it. Deflected wide of the net. Zolotov driven into the boards by Mike Craig, who's just come off the bench. And the puck is shot down the ice. The Canadians ice it to get a line change. 3:22 left in the second. Canada 2, the Soviets 1.
Everyone says you've got to play the body on the Soviets. One-on-one, you've got to look at them, you've got to take the body. Harlock knows that. But it's easier said than done. Kudashev put a nice move on Harlock and then got the shot away.
But Trevor Kidd was there to make the save. Dale Craigwell and Jan Kaminsky. And Kaminsky's waved out of the faceoff circle. Sergei Berezin moves in. Craigwell won the draw. Slaney to Thornton. Took a bump from Kasparaitis and couldn't move the puck out. Slaney could, though. Kaminsky with Craigwell right on him. Pass through center is intercepted. Backhanded in by Martin Lapointe. Lapointe, Craigwell, and Thornton. Look where they're lined up. Thornton's in deep. Lapointe's at the blue line, and Craigwell's behind him almost at center ice. One man in.
They won't press behind that net, not unless they're certain of getting the puck.
Now Lapointe's in after it. Now Craigwell goes for the net, so does Thornton. And the puck came back on the boards all the way into the Canadian zone. Slaney with two men on it. Turned and dumped the puck through center. Thornton gets the puck away from Kasparaitis. Goes wide on Berezin, but he's taken to the boards. Snap towards the goal. Lindros off the bench with Craig. Marshall took the man. Slaney came back and got the puck for Canada. Soviets are changing on the fly as well. Chris Snell to Eric Lindros. Pierre 70 took a shot off a stick to the corner. Mironov trying to clear it, can't do it against Lindros. Now in 70's corner. Kasparaitis is on him. Lindros is over to help out, and he gets the puck to Mike Craig. He was checked in front of the goal by Mironov. Out at center. Berezin couldn't get away from Carl Dykhouse. And the Canadians send the Soviets back in their own zone again. 1:40 left, second period. 2-1 Canada. They had a 2-0 lead after the first. Craig dumped the puck in. Lindros. Weigand came out to poke the puck away from him. Snell thought he kept the puck in, but it's offside.
You've got to like the ingredients on Lindros's line. Sevigny is very good in the corners on the puck. Mike Craig is strong in front of the net, as is Lindros, but Lindros will control the puck the majority of the time, and especially around behind the net. It's his protective zone.
Pierre Sevigny from St. Hyacinthe. St. Hyacinthe, easy for me to say, of the Quebec League, didn't start the tournament on this line. Kent Manderville did, played the exhibition games there. They moved things around to get Manderville on a line with Falloon and Johnson, and that worked very well, and Sevigny has really complimented Lindros and Craigwell.
And at the evaluation camp in the summer, Sevigny had played with Lindros and had played well.
Kudashev to Petrov. Oleg Petrov, centering pass, and a skate in front. Dykhouse cleared it away from the on-rushing Pavel Bure. Soviets like to have their big line on the ice late in the period to try and get a goal. He did in the first, they've done it before in this tournament. Kasparaitis, the defenseman who plays a lot, sent the puck down the ice. Rieskwa back for it. 50 seconds to go in the second period. Nemsnikov. For Kudashev, back to Evgeny Nemsnikov in his third world championship. Sandis Oslich, rink wide. Petrov trips as he turned around to get the puck. Here's Dykhouse moving up. Checked by Nemsnikov. Centering pass in front of the net. Sillinger couldn't tip the puck in. Back come the Soviets. Petrov with 20 seconds to go in the period. Bure moved up, and the puck was taken away from him and sent to center. Lindros is one-on-one against Oslich. Goes for the net. Oslich won the play, getting the puck to the board. Lindros is in after the puck. One last chance. Nobody going for the net. Now they are. Craig shoots it. And Spigen made the save as the buzzer sounded to end the second period. A last second chance for Canada, and I don't know if it would have counted if Craig put it in.
Well, it was a great play, though. Lindros, again, around behind the net and sending that puck out to Mike Craig. Watch, Craig just initially wanted to get that puck right back in behind the net. Why? Well, he knew that Lindros would always be there. He looks for that play. Lindros ducked the check, put it out in front, and Mike Craig was ready to hammer that puck.
And by the time this happened, the buzzer had sounded, the second period was over and is. Sergei Zhultok scored for the Soviet Union. It's a one-goal lead for Canada. Our second intermission features are coming up with our host, Paul Romanek. It hasn't been for most of this tournament. Doesn't seem to have hurt Pavel. Here's Kozlov, number 9. Into the corner, Mike Craig for Canada, number 15. Clears the puck down the ice. And there's an early icing call against Canada.
So what kind of game is Canada going to play in this third period? The first period, they were back and forth. It was a quick-paced period. Little respect at times for the Soviets and doing some banging and crashing. The second period, Dick Todd's troops seemed to lay back a little bit more. More respectful of the Soviets. At the same time, they made very few mistakes. Only one, and that was Harlan.
Off the draw, Craig couldn't get the puck out against Kasparaitis. They both went down. Chris Snell is over for the puck, number 6 for Canada. And he flips it in the air down the ice. Boris Mironov is back. Mironov from the Red Army team. The Kozlov and back. ...18-year-old Mironov. Stick handles through center very slowly. Lindros hooking at him, can't get him. Snell, much smaller, but takes his man to the board. And Eric Lindros clears the puck. Burre keeps it in his corner, back on the point. Kozlov takes a blast. Kidd makes the save. Loose puck. Burre's after it. Shot it off the side of the goal. Soviets have put Burre and Kozlov together. Their best center and their best right winger are playing on a line together, and you'll probably see that throughout this third period. There he is, Kasparaitis. Up the middle, Brisebois cut off the pass. Sergei Zvygin leaves the puck for Kasparaitis. Checked by Rice into the boards, and he went down, and Kasparaitis is hurt. Zolotov was carrying the puck. Kasparaitis hurt when checked by Stephen Rice.
Kasparaitis just went into the boards off balance when Rice hit him. You could see that that left leg of his seemed to jam along the boards.
Gary, I wouldn't be surprised if in the first 40 minutes he played 20 of them. He's been a great defenseman. Look how he does the splits as he gets caught up in the boards.
Well, he's favoring that leg, but he also went to the bench on his own accord, but it doesn't look good for him as he is limping heavily.
Had one look back and a head shake for the referee, who is Heinrich Bjorkman of Sweden. Mike Sillinger, Stephen Rice. On the ice with Pierre Sevigny. There's been some line juggling for Team Canada. There's a shot by Brisebois off the draw, won by Sillinger. Sevigny's in Draper's spot. Kidd makes a save. Big rebound, poked to the front of the net. Another shot is whistled wide of the goal, and Rice comes up with a puck. Flips it through center. Sevigny. Jitnik had him lined up, and the pass was offside. Following tonight's game, stay tuned for our TSN Turning Point, brought to you by National Trust. The official attendance tonight is 11,612 at Saskatchewan Place. That's a full house.
They sold this building out twice. They added 600 bleachers yesterday. They sold that out again.
Jason Marshall from Cranbrook, B.C. to Sevigny. Not out of the line. Jitnik kept it in with a good low shot that didn't miss the net by much. Yashkevich checked at center by Mike Sillinger, who got the puck, and Yashkevich recovered. Kudashov.
I don't like the way the Soviets are really, right from the opening faceoff here, tried to slow the game down a bit. They have too much ability to turn it up again.
Here comes Eric Lindros, barging towards the net. Jitnik stayed with him. Lindros bounced off the boards and lost his helmet. Jitnik has the puck. Manderville comes in to check as well. Zolotov, number 27. Kudashov, number 12. In behind the net, can't center it. Zolotov. Both teams have done some line juggling. Eric Lindros out with Kent Manderville and Greg Johnson on this shift. Now Falloon's out to join Manderville and Johnson. Lindros was out for the faceoff. From the point, Oslin for the shot. Kidd got a piece of that. Korotkov. Žulták couldn't get a shot away. Manderville deep in his own zone. Dykhouse comes back. The centering pass. Oslin from the point. Kidd makes the save. Valery Karpov goes to the corner. Korotkov there with Manderville. Žulták there as well, trying to poke the puck free. And he does. Korotkov. Nemchnikov into a crowd. Kidd makes the save. Big rebound. Falloon cleared it, not out. Hostage with a shot. He scores! 2-2 tie.
It was so easy here to see that coming. Canada could not get the puck out of their own zone. They couldn't get a stoppage in play. They were more worried about taking the body than they were about the puck. It was just a mad scramble, and Canada was getting tired. Lots of traffic in front of Trevor Kidd. Look at it. But Trevor Kidd flipped that puck away rather than trying to dive out and smother it and get a stoppage of play.
An unassisted goal by Sandis Oslinch. At 3:50 of the third period, 2-2 tie. Now you can feel a little tension in the air in this building. Canada had a 2-0 lead after the first. 2-1 at the end of the second. Now it's 2-2. Mironov. To Pavel Bure, number 10, with Oleg Petrov. Bure is caught and checked by Chris Draper. Kept into the point by Mironov as the Canadians can't come out again. Kozlov in on Kidd. Mironov to the net. The Soviets really put on some pressure now. Mike Craig. Out to center, Erik Lindros races after the puck. Pushes Kasparaitis aside. Centering pass, Mironov is there to clear the puck away from Chris Draper. Chris Draper has moved into the spot previously occupied by Pierre Sevigny on a line with Lindros and Craig. Vic Todd has done some line juggling for the third period. As is Robert Cherenkov. Here's Oleg Petrov. Kozlov goes for the net. Shot it wide. Loose puck at the side of the goal. Petrov was checked and knocked down. Out at center ice comes Mike Craig, number 15, with Lindros. Lindros in after the puck. Check to the boards. Kasparaitis gets the puck and clears it. Zolotov, number 27. Zhitnik, number 5, moves up, takes the shot. Marshall got a piece of that and sent it wide of the goal. 5 minutes and 10 seconds into the third period, now in a 2-2 tie. Rice to the blue line and over. Zolotov, number 27, and a delayed offside is called against Canada as Zolotov carried the puck deep into his own zone.
Soviets were playing a little possum at the start of this third period. They slowed the tempo down until they hit Canada's blue. Then they started turning it on. They started forechecking, laying the body on a little bit, digging that puck out. What we haven't seen them do, as much as we thought we'd see them do, is go wide on the Canadian defense. They've so often held up at the blue line, looking for someone to come up with them so they could make the pass.
Chris Snell dumped the puck in off the faceoff. Rice went to the net as the puck bounced out front, and the Soviets clear it. Mike Sillinger with Rice and Sevigny in over the blue line. Oslinch back in his own zone, knocked down by Stephen Rice. Kudashov over the blue line. Korotkov with a weak backhander on Trevor Kidd. And he holds on. 14:09 to go to goal in a 2-2 tie. Tie game favors the Soviets. They'll still get gold. A tie game gives Canada a bronze. A loss, and Canada doesn't get a medal. They want to win for gold. Shot off the draw by Mutkoff is blocked by Kidd in front. Karpov's shot, and Kidd stopped him. Valery Karpov with a great chance, and Kidd got his legs across and made the save.
Kent Manderville for Canada gains center and dumps the puck in. Pat Falloon in the right wing against Mironov. Can't come up with the puck. Karatchov. Joltok dumps the puck in. And Pat Falloon is back. Patrice Brisebois. To Pat Falloon and up to center. Forrest Mironov fires it back in on Kidd offside against the Soviets.
Oh, a great chance for the Soviets. Karpov had the puck to the right of Trevor Kidd, and Kidd went down early. Karpov had the top of the net. He just couldn't get that stick on the puck and get it up and over Karpov.
Valery Karpov.
And Trevor Kidd stopped it.
Trevor Kidd was down. There was lots of room up top. Karpov couldn't find it.
Hasn't had much luck in any of the games by the looks of his stats in the tournament. Craig Lindros and Draper out for Canada now against the big line of the Soviets. Kozlov, Petrov, and Pavel Bure, who shoots. Shot was blocked. Mike Craig. Eric Lindros now bumps with Osling. Two big boys. Kozlov back the other way. Petrov's in front, so is Bure. Mike Craig after the puck. Hooks Bure to the ice. And Chris Snell plays the puck for Kyle Dykhouse.
Canada have to move the puck in their own zone quicker.
There's a giveaway to Petrov with Kozlov. The drop pass. Bure's been knocked down. Petrov's in front of the net. Dykhouse takes Kozlov. And there's penalties being called. I believe it'll be coincident penalties to Craig and Bure. We'll be back in a moment. The Pavel Bure and Mike Craig at 7:22 of the third period in a 2-2 tie.
So a scoring threat for both teams gone. Opens up the ice a little bit in international play.
Alexei Zhitnik, Darius Kasparaitis. There's Zhitnik. Number five, what a great skater. Holds up, fell down. Kasparaitis. To Zhitnik. Alexei Kudashov. Pass for Zolotov. Tipped out of the air by Slaney and into the stand. Last night they thought they might be playing, hoping for a silver. Now they're embroiled in a gold medal game after a reprieve from Finland.
This is Lindros and Mrs. May. A little nervous, I would think.
A little.
Okay, a lot nervous.
Yeah. Dick Todd has done some line juggling. He put Chris Draper with Lindros and Craig, obviously, to counter Kozlov, Petrov, and Bure being put together. The Soviets put all their big guys in one line. So it really becomes at even strength situations. When they're at full strength, Draper's job to check Pavel Bure.
Mm-hmm. Draper, one of the best defensive players on Team Canada.
Now it's Lindros and Draper against Petrov and Kozlov. That's the forward matchup. Oleg Petrov ran into Kozlov and went down. Dykhouse, or Harlech make that, moves up on the play and dumps the puck in, and Boris Mironov is back.
And Lindros was tripped up at the blue line.
Oleg Petrov tries to split the defense, goes down, hoping to draw a penalty, nothing doing. Henrik Bjorkman will have none of it. 8.5 minutes into the third period. Canada 2, the Soviets 2.
The Soviets are sure running the interference on Eric Lindros when he tries to get into the offensive zone.
Draper steals the puck. The pass for Lindros was knocked away by Boris Mironov. Zoltok over the blue line. His shot was blocked. Back comes Draper to Lindros. One man back. Goes for the net. Scooped it wide. Draper taken to the board by Nemsnikov. Gave him a little punch as they came off the board. Slava Kozlov went wide on Dykhouse, 2-on-1. Zoltok in front, mishandled the puck. Canada caught a break there. Back they come. Lindros with Dykhouse, 2-on-2. Dykhouse goes for the net. The late man is Snell into the corner. Pat Balloon couldn't get the puck back to Snell, and the Soviets come out. The penalties to Craig and Bure have expired. They're back on the ice. Karatkov to the blue line and no further. 10.5 minutes to go in the game. Mike Craig tried to steal the puck and couldn't. Oslich up on the right wing. Valery Karpov chases the puck. John Slaney picks up speed as he comes out of his own end through center. In on the right wing. Lost the puck as he's checked by Yushkevich. In behind the net, Manderville. Checked by Yushkevich. Zitnik. Alexei Zitnik. Fell again. And if something wrong with his skates, that's happened to him a couple of times in recent moments.
Defensively, very seldom are you going to beat the Soviets on a one-on-one.
Rice got the puck to the end board. Then it comes all the way around, and out comes Zolotov, number 27. Kudashov takes the shot, blocked by Kidd, scooped away from the front of the net by John Slaney. Canadians are making changes. Yushkevich to Kasparaitis. Dmitry Yushkevich, number 3, drops it off. Bure came back in his own zone. Now he sprints through center as the pass goes to Petrov. Friesbois is back, and he clears the puck. Kozlov dumped it inside the blue line. Out comes Friesbois carrying the puck. Turned it over. Petrov with Kozlov. Bure trailing. Petrov to Kozlov. Didn't get much of a shot away. Friesbois is back deep in his own zone. 9 minutes to go. Canada 2 and the Soviets 2. Pierre Sevigny with Sillinger and Craig over the blue line. Dick Todd can't get his matchup right now. Lindros and Draper have just had a long shift. They would normally be out against Kozlov's line. Chris Snell intercepted a Soviet pass.
Canada's defense are starting to take a few too many liberties offensively. Griesbach tried to do it all himself, then Snell jumped up.
Petrov was blasted to the ice by Mike Sillinger. Mike Craig dumps the puck in. Oslich. Long pass out of center. Hit Karpov in the skate. Snell to Falloon. In over the blue line. Draper for Lindros, blocked by Oslich. In front of the goal for Falloon. It's swept away from him by Mironov. Now Snell with just over 8 minutes to go. His pass went off a Soviet into the stands. 2-2 tie at Saskatchewan Place. A win for the gold for Canada. A tie is good for bronze. A loss, no medal at all. At what point do you start to go for the win and the gold?
Well, all I think Canada's got to do right now, Jim, is get back to the way they started this game out. Dumping that puck in, making sure they've got one man high, but getting two men in on top of the puck quickly.
Manderville and Johnson are the first men in right now. Nemsnikov, bad pass, Manderville's shot. Zweigin made the save. Zoltok up the boards, and the Soviets get the puck to center. Bashkatov knocked down at center. Kudashov plays the puck back to Evgeny Nemsnikov. Kudashov takes a shot. Kidd kicks it out. Cleared down the ice. No icing as Nemsnikov comes back to pick it up. Manderville and Falloon into forecheck. Now they start backing up. Zolotov into the middle. Bashkatov couldn't come up with the puck. Kozlov back on the ice. He's playing a lot in the third. Slava Kozlov joined by Petrov and Bure now as Kidd comes out of his net and covers up. 7:14 to go in the game in a 2-2 tie. Here's Paul.
Well, this is just a warm-up for a great season of junior hockey ahead on TSN. CHL Sunday night premieres Wednesday, January the 9th, 7:30 Eastern. Cornwall and Belleville. It all culminates in May with the Memorial Cup Championship from Quebec City.
We wish you well on your travels, Paul, and may every game you call be like this one. Carl Dykhouse off a draw won by Sillinger. Shot towards the net. Sillinger's back for it. Down in the boards for Draper, who's out against Bure again. Back with Sillinger and Rice. Yushkevich, number three. Up the boards to Petrov. Out come the Soviets. Kozlov goes wide in the right wing. Burris trailing on the play. Kozlov for the net. Kidd stopped him at the side of the goal. Snell to Sillinger. Gave it away at the line. Chitnik with a shot. Tipped in front. Loose puck. And the Soviets couldn't put it by Trevor Kidd. Petrov to Kozlov. Can't get a shot. Yushkevich. Backhand shot. Kidd makes the save. The loose puck in front. Burry was knocked down as he tried to backhand it. Carl Dykhouse starts out for Canada. 6:25 to go in the game. Draper's in after Yushkevich. Right on top of him. And on top of the puck, Sillinger comes in against Zitnik. Yushkevich is up. Up the middle to Zsoltok. Sergei Zsoltok checked into the boards. Hit off the glass by Brisbois to center. Boris Mironov. The long blast in on Kidd. Canada's managed only two shots on goal in the third period. Karatkov to the front of the net. Karpov tipped the puck just wide.
Canada are back on their heels too much.
There's Eric Lindros, ran into traffic. Darius Kasparaitis gets the puck through center. Soviets have outshot them 9-2 in the third and scored the only goal to tie this game 2-2. Lindros in after Mironov. Pass for Karpov, got by him and all the way down the ice, icing against the Soviets. 5:25 left in the game, it's a 2-2 tie. Junior Championship, the gold medal game, 5:25 left in it, and it's a 2-2 tie. Greg Johnson won the draw. John Sweeney dumped the puck to the corner. Johnson centering pass. Kudashov is there to take it away for the Soviets. Up the boards, can't get it out. Sweeney blasts for it.
Describe the feeling in this crowd.
It's a goal that spans Canada. Jason Marshall from Cranbrook, B.C. to John Sweeney from St. John's, Newfoundland, and Canada leads by one. First of the tournament for Sweeney, but still 5 minutes to go in the game. Only the third shot on goal for Canada in the third period. Now the Soviets' big line is out on the ice, but Canada's after the puck. Sillinger overskated it. Here's Pavel Bure, Oleg Petrov. Kozlov takes the shot, blocked by Dykhouse. Kozlov again with a shot. Deflected to the corner. Steven Rice is the first man back. Slipped and fell. Bure got the puck, pulled under him by Rice. And he stops the play with 4:44 to go.
God knows that's a long 4:44. Another look at the goal. And Manderville could have dunked it if he was a basketball player. Not everyone in this crowd tonight, along the best seats, are cheering for their sons. That's Mary Todd, Dick Todd's wife, and his daughter, all painted up in the festive spirit.
Anybody got any nails left? .437 to go.
I didn't have any coming into this game. After the Czech game, the Swede game.
John Slaney scored. Here's his mom. Good reason to scream. Pierre Sevigny jumps the puck down the ice. Yushkevich back for it. Icing against Canada. They know curling out here and felt that one was still in the house.
And it's been tough today with face-offs. Canada and the Soviets pretty much even. Sevigny just got dumped on the ice.
He went down again. I think this time he bumped into Sergei Zolotov and went down, maybe trying to draw a penalty. Stirring the pot. Lindros and Karapkov in the faceoff. Back to the point. Zhitnik kept it in for the Soviets. Lindros, the first man back for it. Around the boards for Mike Craig. Can't move it out. Up the boards. Yushkevich keeps it in at the left point. Zolotov in for Karpov behind the net. Valery Karpov has control. Then he gave it away, and Sevigny to Banks and cleared it.
That second man in for Canada in the corners in their own end zone has got to look for the puck. They're still thinking about the body. First man can do that. Second man's got to take the puck.
3 minutes and 45 seconds to go. Blasted in by Karapkov. Canada must win to win gold. Pierre Sevigny dumps the puck in, plays it on the boards, works the clock. Lindros picks up the puck. 3.5 minutes to go. Yushkevich. Jan Kaminski up the middle. Dykhouse got it to the Soviet blue line. There's an interception and Manderville moves in looking for insurance. Balloon and Johnson hang back. Now Johnson goes to the front of the net. Manderville putting up a fight on the boards. Comes out with the puck. Dykhouse plays the puck on the boards for Pat Balloon. Johnson to the inboards. Manderville working the clock beautifully. Johnson in behind the net. Balloon's out front. Soviets clear the puck. Can't get it by Manderville. Now in a second effort they do. Zolotov, number 27, couldn't handle a pass. 2 minutes and 40 seconds to go.
That puck went off the backboard but didn't cross the line, so it wasn't icing.
Kozlov dumped the puck in. Griesbois, the first man back for Canada. To the blue line and out. Draper doesn't know it's there. Kasparaitis has the puck. The Soviets' big line is on the ice. Kozlov, Petrov, Pavel Bure. And Bure has the puck. Almost gave it away. Petrov checked the clock. Took a hit. Bure has to go back for the puck. Under two to go. Over the blue line, Kasparaitis is turned back. Mironov dumps the puck in. Harlech sends it down the ice. Icing against Canada. 1:45 to go.
Harlech knew that Dick Todd wanted a line change, but I don't think Harlech intended to throw the puck down the ice for an icing. He was trying to bank it off and have it just lay in the zone.
Oh, Mary still had the wherewithal to check her ticket numbers on the 50-50 draw. She could win big twice tonight.
The only draw Dick Todd is worried about, though, is the one in his own end zone.
He'll assign Eric Lindros to that. What a magnificent game. What magnificent games over the last week.
Sevigny and Harlock are continuing to talk to Kordikov.
Slowly they get their players ready. Two to nothing Canada after the first. 2-1 Canada after the second. The shots on goal in the third period. Canada has 3. The Soviets have 14. They've had trouble getting the bench door closed. All of that gives Eric Lindros a little more rest. Eric, better no face-off. Lindros and Kropkov.
They're both waved out of there for their pushing and shoving.
Now it's Craig against Žolták. Mike Craig wants to make sure everyone's positioned well. Off the draw, Craig gets the puck up the boards, not out. Now they're on a second effort to get it to center. A minute and a half to go. Canada 3, Soviets 2. In over the blue line, Dykhouse turns the Soviets back. Shitnik. 1:20 to go. Žolták goes wide on Marshall. Taken down. No call from Bjorkman now. 1:10 to go, and the Canadians get the puck out of their zone. Kropkov. All the Canadians are back inside the blue line. Kidd holds on. 58 seconds to go.
As much as possible, Dick Todd will delay this game. Dick Todd, sit down. Now's the time to catch your wind. Save the legs.
Tell whose timeout it is. I'm assuming Canada's, but they're taking so much extra time, and Chedenkov doesn't mind. He wants to talk to his player. The Soviets have pulled their goaltender. Schweigen is out. A tie, remember, and the Soviets strike gold. Canada can only win gold with the victory. 6 attackers will be inside the line, and this will be one last shift in the game. Lindros against Bure. They're both on the ice.
This is the biggest faceoff Eric Lindros has ever taken in his life.
He's up against Slava Kozlov. Lindros won the draw cleanly. Craig couldn't move the puck out. To the point, Yushkevich shoots into a crowd, a rolling puck went wide. Canadians frantically try and clear it and do get the puck to center. Yushkevich, Mirnin off and right back in on Trevor Kidd. Lindros is there, flip the puck in the air, out of play. 39 seconds to go. You were wrong, Greener. This is the biggest face-off of Eric Lindros' life.
Well, he won the last one cleanly.
He'll face off against Svatokoslav again.
This time, if he wins it cleanly, Dykhouse has got to get that puck up and over the defense and the blue line into the neutral zone at least.
To the front of the net. Petrov scrambled after the puck. Lindros flips it in the air. It won't get to the net. Icing.
No, Jim, this next faceoff might be the biggest faceoff in Erik Lindros' life. How many more of them are we going to have?
16-3 are the shots on goal for the Soviets in the third. But Canada has a one-goal lead on John Slaney's first of the tournament at 14:47. Can Lindros win another? Kasparaitis moves up on the puck. Lindros slid into him. Lindros back for the puck. Sends it out to center. Chris Draper can't put it in the open net. 10 seconds to go. Canada has struck gold.
Jim, there were those that doubted the choice of Dick Todd as the head coach. There are none now.
Lindros just threw his stick up to his mom. Canada has won back-to-back gold medals. Safe to say Team Finland will own the town tonight.
And you know something, Jim? I think they might even treat Finland. So loud in this place, I can't even hear.
coach's wife and daughter. Slovakia to get gold. A Newf named Wayne Norris scored the winner. And this year, Newfoundland has sent the goal scorer to the cup again, to the World Championship. John Slady from St. John scored tonight's winner.
It'll be a very happy night on the rock tonight.
You got it. The bedlam subsides on the ice, at least at one end, for just a moment. Time for the official presentations, the closing ceremonies on the ice. Canada's player of the game, Chris Draper.
Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you please rise for Team Canada's national anthem in recognition of tonight's winning team.
This is always a special moment at the World Championship, but particularly when it's on home ice.